So welcome back. Let's discuss the chapter further. Till here we discussed the type of tribal peoples and how they earn their livelihood. Till here we explained that they practice shifting cultivation and they also gather some forest product. They collect from the forest and after that they sell in the market. So here is a question arise that every time are they depending on fruits and roots of the plants only? They never use wheat or any other grain in their food. So here is a question. If they use, so from where they get rice and other grains? So let's see. At time they exchange goods, getting what they need in return for their valuable forest produce. In last video also I explained that the surplus of their forest produce. For surplus means, for example, they collect 80 apples from the forest but they consume only 50. Okay, so 30 is surplus. If we deduct 80 from the 50, means 30 is extra one. Means extra means surplus only. So they will sell these 30 apples in the market and for that they will get money, and from that money they are able to purchase anything which they need, like rice or any other food grain or any other thing. Like in last video also we discussed that they also purchase plush flowers for purchasing for their particular purpose. Okay, so now see, yes, some of them did odd jobs. They also used to do so many type of job. If they don't have any particular land to cultivate, if they don't have any particular forest to collect anything, so they can do jobs also, like carrying loads, building roads, theek hai, jaise, and laboring in the field of peasant and farmers. If they are landless labor, so they can work in the land of farmers or peasants, or on the land of zamindar, and from there they can get money. When supply of forest produce shrank, tribal people had to increasingly wander around in search of work as laborers. When they are not getting enough products from the forest and from the crop which they are cultivating in their patch of lands, then they have to do work as a labor, because if they will not do any job, then how they will earn their livelihood? So, but Baigas of Central India. See, where is Baigas? Baigas is over here. ठीक है, और बायगास ऑफ द सेंट्रल एरिया समार इन हियर छत्तीसगढ़ ऑल्सो. सो दे रिलेक्टेंट टू डू वर्क फॉर अदर्स. दे थिंक दैट दीज आर फ्रॉम दिस इज नॉट आर ट्रेडिशन टू डू वर्क ऑन अदर्स लैंड एज लेबर. ओके, दे थिंक दैट इट इज नॉट अ वर्क एज अ नॉट अ वर्क फॉर देयर डिग्निटी. दे थिंक अपार्ट फ्रॉम देयर डिग्निटी दैट इफ वी आर tribal people and if we are Baigas tribe, then it is not good for our tribe that we are doing work as a laborer in others field. So we should work being a tribe in forest only. Okay, so it was below the dignity of Baigas to become a laborer. Now tribal group often needed to buy and sell in order to be able to get goods that were not produced within the locality. So oftenly they purchase the goods which they are not able to get there from their forest, or which they are not getting in their forest. This led to their dependence on traders and money lenders. Like for those particular period, they depend on money lenders and landlords also. Trader came around with things for sale and sold the goods at high price, because traders know that they don't have that particular product or thing. So trader came over there, they sell those particular things to them at very high price. Moneylender gave loan with which the tribal meet their cash needs. But that tribal people also don't have sufficient amount, because they use that amount for paying their loan which they are getting from the money lenders. Adding to what they earn, So but the interest charge on the loans are usually very high. Of course, if you are getting loan from the money lender, then the interest of that particular loan will be very high. So for the tribal market and commerce often meet debt and poverty only. Means market and trade related activities, they are not fruitful or beneficial or profitable for these tribal peoples. By their the market increase their debt only, and which leads to the poverty. They therefore came to see the moneylender and trader as evil outsider and the cause of their misery. So here the moneylenders and the traders, these are the evil outsiders for them, who didn't work for their benefit, who just only connected with the tribal people for only their profit. So that's why these are the evil outsiders for these tribal people. They think that they are not good for us because they are not giving us actual price to us for our anything, whether it's money on the land, whether anything which they want to purchase from the traders. Next is some herded animals. Many tribal group live in herding and rearing animals. They were pastoralists who move with their herds of cattle and sheep according to the season. Herded peoples mean they rear so many types of animals which can fulfill their needs. Okay, and they move from one place to the another place also with their animals. If they are having goat, if they are having sheep, they move. They live at a particular place and they rear animals also, and they use grass or forest nearby them for the grazing of their fruit. And when all these resources are exhausted, then they move to the another place with their animals only. Okay, so these are called herded peoples. Yes, so here is one Gujar of Punjab Hills. Labadis of Andhra Pradesh were cattle herder, and Gaddis of Kullu. Kullu means in Shimla, Gaddis of Kullu were shepherd. Bakarwals of Kashmir rear goats. And like this, there are so many tribal people who rear animals also. And these are very important for your NTSC also, that one Gujar are belong to which state, and Gaddis of Kullu was shepherd, like this. It can be a question in your paper. Okay. So now, what is next? Look to settled cultivation. See, till now we studied about shifting cultivation, in which they need to move from one place to the another place. But here we are also having a point of settled cultivation, in which they settle at one place only and they practice cultivation. So before 19th century, many from within the tribal group had begun settle down and cultivating their field in one place year after year. Like, they are not practicing shifting cultivation. Okay, they began to use ploughing and gradually got right over that particular land. From before 19th century, they are living at that particular place only, and they used to use that particular land for their cultivation. So after that they get right over that particular land they live on. Okay, many cases like Mundas of Chota Nagpur, the land belonged to the clans as a whole. Clan means group of peoples of that particular tribe. And the land which they are cultivating, it belongs to complete clan instead of a single individual or the one who is cultivating that land. Means a complete clan has the right over that particular land. After that, because in that land all the peoples are of that particular tribe only. So if they want to earn their livelihood, they work on that particular land collectively, and collectively they divide whatever they are getting from that particular land. Then very often some people within the clan acquire more powers than others. Some become chiefs and other followers. If someone is more powerful in that particular land, so that person declared himself as a chief or head of the clan, and other follow him only. Powerful men often rented out their land instead of cultivating it themselves. Many powerful men, what they did, they provide their land to the landless laborers, and from there they are getting their earning instead of cultivating it by themselves. British officials saw settled tribal groups like the Gonds and Santhals. Gonds and Santhal are settled communities who settle at a one place only, and there they are cultivating their land. Those who live in the forest were considered to be wild and savage. They needed to be settled and civilized. Britishers said that the one who is settled at one place are beneficial for them, and the one who is living in forest are considered to be wild, and they need to settle or civilize those people also, because if they want to collect revenue, so they can collect it easily from the one who is settled at that particular land. Okay, so here, how did colonial rule affect tribal peoples? Because they want revenue from all the tribal groups, so it is very easy for them to collect from the one who is settled as compared to them who are moving from one place to the another place. So, first question is, what happened to the tribal chiefs? Tribal chiefs means Britishers are here who are imposing their rules and regulation on these peoples, and if the Britishers are there to rule over that particular clan or tribe, so what happened to the clan chief, the one who is declare himself as the chief, so what happened to him? So see how they tickle the situation. Before the arrival of Britishers, in many areas the tribal chiefs were important people, because everybody need to follow them only. They enjoy a certain amount of economic power and had the right to administer and control their territories. They are having economic power also. If they are chief, then already told you that landless labor work on their particular land, and from there they earn profit. So like this, they can more powerful or more having more economic powers. They're having right on their territory also, and they can control how they want to control. In some places, they had their own policies and decide on the local rules of land and forest management. On the many places, they impose their rules and regulation only, and they are having their own policies. They were allowed to keep their land titles over a cluster of village and rent out lands. But they lost much of their administrative power and were forced to follow laws made by the British officials in India. Because now Britishers are there to control their particular land. So Britishers are taking their all the powers. They said that now you are part of that, you can say, clan or tribe. But ultimately rules will be followed by us only. You will take care that everyone is following our rules or not. Now, what happened to the shifty cultivators? We will understand it next video.